हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शेफाली राहुल घुटके, करंटली वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, एक्रेडिटेड विद नैक ए प्लस ग्रेड. आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन टूडेज लेक्चर विच इज जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग लेक्चर. सो इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ एक्सपांसिव सॉइल, वॉट ट्रीटमेंट वी कैन टेक फॉर एक्सपांसिव सॉइल, and how we carried the foundation on expansive soil. So basically, this is the outline of our presentation. It includes definition, causes of expansion, problems, and solution. So what is expansive soil? Expansive soil are that type of a soil that easily get swells when water is added and shrinks when they dried out. The expansive soil has considerable strength in a dry stretch, but the strength ultimately goes on reducing on the absorption of a water. The soil exerts considerable pressure on the foundation during the swelling. Expansive soil basically contains the different minerals such as montmorillonite, illite, and kaolinite. These minerals are basically capable to absorb the water. If suppose when illite and kaolinite are present in clay soil, in that condition it exhibit the large volume reduction on drying. In India, these expansive soil are known by the different names, by the local names, such as black cotton soil in central India, bentonite in Rajasthan and Kashmir, mar or kabar in Uttar Pradesh. It means in different state of India, the expansive soil has its own different names. So these soil mainly basically occupy about 30 to 40% of the total land of the India. As you can see in this map, the grayish part shows the black cotton soil, which you can see in the Maharashtra region, Madhya Pradesh region. It means in the central part of India, you can see the black cotton soil. So what are the basically causes that are responsible for the creation of expansion in the soil? So these reasons are rain, because of the lawn and garden watering creates a moist zone on the exterior of a foundation. Cesspool. This cesspool basically are the underground temporary storage for the liquid waste and the sewage waste. The next one is septic tank. Septic tank are the underground storage tank for the domestic wastewater flow. Next one is leaky pipe and the swimming pool. Basically, these are the reason which are ultimately creates the expansion in the soil. Now, what are the problems which creates because of the expansion nature of the soil? When the expansive soil are present, they will generally not cause a problem if their water content remains the constant. If suppose there is no change in the water contained, in that case, there is no harmful reason because of the expansive nature of the soil. As the situation where the greatest damage occur is when there are significant or the repeated moisture contained changes. The expansive soil usually won't have a problem with the heavy structure, but with the light structure and the pavement. Because of the expansive nature of the soil, because of the increases in the volume of the soil, there is a uplift pressure creation because of the expansive nature. So if there is a heavy structure, in that case the heavy structure will automatically counterbalance the uplift pressure. But if there is a light structure, in that case there is a problem of differential settlement. Deep excavation for foundation. As we know, the black cotton soil are द रेसिडुअल सॉइल विच इज रिजल्टिंग फ्रॉम द वेदरिंग ऑफ अ इग्नियस रॉक्स दैट इज बेसाल्ट. द थिकनेस ऑफ अ सॉइल स्ट्रेटम कैन बी हाई एज 3 to 10 meters. लेइंग द फाउंडेशन ऑन अ फर्म नॉन स्वेलिंग स्ट्रेटम इन्वॉल्व द डीप एक्सकेवेशन इन अ स्टीफ क्ले एंड विच अल्टीमेटली इंक्रीजेस द कॉस्ट ऑफ अ कंस्ट्रक्शन. Now, the assumption. The correct estimation of allowable bearing capacity of a black cotton soil which is easily get swell is complicated because of the various factors such as its swelling pressure, groundwater table variation. There is a continuous fluctuation in the groundwater table, and because of the site condition, there is a difficulty for the correction of allowable bearing capacity. Okay, so in that condition, this leads to the assumption of low bearing capacity. But if suppose the probable swelling is much more higher than the bearing capacity, in that case, the foundation are subjected to differential settlement. So the cracking of single storied building is very much common that of a double storied building. Non-uniform swelling or shrinkage. The equilibrium water content is not same below the foundation. This leads to the differential settlement and the diagonal cracking of a masonry structure because of the expansive nature of the soil. The building gets easily cracked. High cost and low reliability of a rehabilitation. Remedial measures for the damaged structure are costly and non-reliable in the long term. Hence, always prevention is better than cure. This is the lift of a floor slab. In first figure, you can see there is a uniformly vertical loading which is acting on a rectangular slab. After that, because of the expansive nature, the slab lift up at the corner because there is less confinement. So the uniform swell pressure is a non-uniform direction and moment. In figure number 2, we can say there is a continuous fluctuation of a soil in the corner. So there is a less confinement. Or in figure number 3, you can see as the vertical loads increase, in that condition, the swell moment get decreases. So, as you can see, there is a swell moment more in the corner and the least at the center of the slab. So, this is the loss of a skin friction of a pier. Basically, the skin friction is the friction between the surrounding soil and the pier material. In rainy season, because of the expansive nature of the soil, the skin friction becomes negative and it acts in the upward direction. As you can see in first figure, this pink line shows the negative skin friction which is act in the upward direction. So after 5 to 10 days storm, the soil expand when it wets. Okay, so as you can see in third figure, because of the dry weathering, there is a shrinkage of a soil. So because of the shrinkage, there is a formation of a crack. This is the uplift pressure. This is the crack formation because of the uplift pressure in the interior wall. And these are the diagonal deep cracks because of the uplift pressure of the expansive nature of the soil, which is very severe in nature. Solutions. Replacing the expansion soil under the foundation, we can replace the expansive soil under the foundation. Even we can change the nature of expansive soil by adding some cementitious material, and we can strengthening the structure to withstand the heave, that is uplift pressure, and we can construct the structure such that the structure are flexible enough to withstand the differential soil heave without the failure on constructing the isolated deep foundation below the depth of a active zone. Active zone is at a depth. There is a continuous fluctuation in the moisture change, replacing the expansive soil. The first and the very simple method is to remove the entire layer of expansive soil. We can easily remove the expansive soil and fill that place with some new soil that are having less expansive nature as compared to first one. Okay. So also we can change the nature of expansion soil by compacting, pre-wetting, by the installation of moisture barriers, or we can do the chemical stabilization of a soil. Compaction. The heave, that is the uplift pressure which is generated by the expansion nature of a soil, that can be minimized by compacting to a lower unit weight on the high side of the optimum moisture content, which can be possibly 3 to 4% above the optimum moisture content. Now, the pre-wetting. Basically, the wetting of a soil before the construction, we can do the wetting before the construction so that most of the uplift that created because of the expansion nature will form before the construction itself. So this technique may be time consuming because the seepage of the water takes place in plastic clay is very low. So it took 15 to 20 days. So the construction will be delayed. After the ponding, 4 to 5% of hydrated lime may be added to the top layer of the soil to make it less plastic and more workable. We can even add 4 to 5% of hydrated lime to reduce the expansion nature of the soil. Installation of a moisture barrier. The long-term effect of the differential heave can be reduced by controlling the moisture variation in the soil. This is achieved by basically providing the vertical moisture barriers along the perimeter of the construction. These moisture barriers may be constructed in the trenches which filled with the lean concrete or the gravels or maybe some impervious membrane. As you can see in this picture, these is nothing but the protective coating which is provided at the periphery of the building so that it ultimately reduces the moisture content. Next is chemical stabilization of a soil. Chemical stabilization with the aid of a lime and cement. Lime or cement that can be added with the top layer of the soil and it can be compacted. The addition of a lime or cement will ultimately decreases the liquid limit, plastic limit, and ultimately it decreases the swell characteristics of the soil. This can be done up to a depth of 1 to 1.5 meter. If it is done up to 2 to 3 meter, in that case, the cost of a construction may be more. So we done this method up to a depth of 1 to 1.5 meters. Hydrated high calcium lime and dolomite lime are generally used for the lime stabilization. We generally use the hydrated high calcium lime and dolomite lime. Pressure injection of a lime slurry or lime fly ash slurry. We can stabilize by adding the lime slurry, usually up to a depth of 4 to 5 meter and occasionally deeper to cover the active zone, which ultimately reduces the swelling property of a soil. This is the under rim pile, which are basically used for the black cotton soil. In this under rimmed pile, the under rim burls are provided into the pile foundation to reduce the moisture content of a soil. Next, the last part is conclusion. It is possibly to build successfully and safely कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑन एक्सपांसिव सॉइल इफ द स्टेबल मॉइस्चर कंटेंट कैन बी मेंटेन्ड और इफ द बिल्डिंग कैन बी इंसुलेटेड फ्रॉम एनी सॉइल चेंजेस दैट माइट अकर. द प्रोसीजर फॉर सक्सेस इज एज फॉलोज. वी कैन टेस्ट एंड आइडेंटिफाई इफ देयर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम. वी कैन डिजाइन द स्ट्रक्चर टू मिनिमाइज द मॉइस्चर कंटेंट चेंजेस एंड वी कैन इंसुलेट इट फ्रॉम द सॉइल वॉल्यूम चेंजेस. बिल्ड इन सच अ वे दैट इट विल नॉट चेंज द मॉइस्चर कंडीशन ऑफ द सॉइल. वी कैन अगेन मेंटेन अ कॉन्स्टेंट मॉइस्चर एनवायरमेंट आफ्टर द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ अ स्ट्रक्चर. सो इट इज पॉसिबल टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑन द एक्सपांसिव सॉइल. थैंक यू.